Opposition legislators today held a caucus meeting to review their boycott of parliamentary sittings, which has entered the third week, as they demand for government to respond on the fate of the 18 victims of enforced disappearances and violations of rights of leaders and opposition. Addressing the press after the closed-door meeting, the chief opposition whip announced that they have decided to maintain their boycott since government has maintained a deaf ear on their demands.
We, as the opposition, entire opposition in the 11th Parliament, have decided to continue with the just cause of boycotting the plenary in order to have a meaningful debate on issues of human rights violations in Uganda. Because as we talk, our major focus is on the missing persons, which even the report of the Human Rights Commission has alluded to.
While speaking to journalists at Parliament this afternoon, the opposition chief whip, John Baptist Nambesha, said they are not about to return to the House until they get answers.
We have even many more mysterious disappearances of the citizenry in other parts of the country. Eastern, Northern, mention it. All these lists we have. So the information I have for you is that our boycott is still on, and we are not about to relent or throw our hands into the air to call it off until our demands are yielded to by the government. Don't you get shocked if the House leadership fails to run the House and maybe even seek for other escape routes, including a recess.
The Shadow Minister of Information, Joyce Bagala, noted that they're going to engage a bigger gear by releasing a documentary of all victims of abductions. She says the documentary will come in bits starting tomorrow to enhance their campaign.
We continue the boycott, but also we thought it was imperative, it was our duty to provide information to the public, to provide information to the regime, to provide information to Mariam Wangadia and her commission, if they think or if they're saying these people don't exist. So we have gone to all the families of the 18 missing Ugandans, and we've come out with a documentary. This documentary premieres tomorrow. It is in 18 episodes, every day of 18 days, starting tomorrow.
This evening, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, has sent Parliament on a 2 weeks recess on account of giving parliamentary committees to carry out oversight on budget implementation. But the chief opposition whip, Nambesha, says the action was informed by the stalemate in the House caused by opposition, which has refused to call off the boycott.
As leadership, we have mounted lots of pressure. And they should not even be shocked or mortified if the speaker eventually fails to run the House and calls it a day, because we are not joking subject on this matter of human rights violations this time around.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.